Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Nothing is stopping Errol Spence versus Terrence Bud Crawford. And look, let's break it down honestly and objectively as possible. And as we know that Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford is a fight that's been often talked about as one guy ducking the other. One guy's trying to collect belt. One guy's fighting this. One guy's doing that. And at the end of the day, none of those things matter because both of those guys can get it on now. Nothing is stopping either one of these guys from fighting next. And let me break it down. When you look at it, you see your Deniz Ugas is already booked. He already has a mandatory that he has to fight next. That's already on the table. And we've already seen Errol Spence, you know, come out and state that he wants to fight for a title next. Tune-up fights are for guys who are unsure of themselves. So he does not feel that he's unsure of himself. He wants to fight for a title in his next fight. And your Deniz Ugas is booked. So that naturally leads you to believe that the only fight next for Errol Spence Jr. is Terrence Bud Crawford. Errol Spence doesn't need a tune-up. Errol Spence saying he doesn't want a tune-up, so he should be willing to fight Terrence Crawford next. You know, you've seen in the past that Errol Spence and Terrence Crawford both stated that Bob Arum is the reason why these fights can't happen. He's the reason that the fights have been holding up and they can't make the fights and they can't negotiate and they can't reach a number. They've both said this. Terrence Crawford has admitted Bob Arum has been a problem, and Errol Spence has admitted that Bob Arum has been a problem. So the great thing that we have here is the fact that Terrence Crawford is no longer with Bob Arum. He is now a free agent. He can fight anywhere on any platform with anyone. So at the end of the day, there's nothing holding up this fight. There's no promoter stopping this fight. Your Deniz Ugas is not there for, you know, Errol Spence to fight next. So the only natural fight for both of these guys to fight next is each other. There's nothing stopping Terrence Crawford and Errol Spence from fighting next. That fight needs to happen next. Why delay it? When they both want to fight a champion, when they both want to unify, there is no promoter dividing these guys. So what is stopping it? This fight needs to happen next. It makes the most sense. See, because what you don't want to happen is a Joshua Wilder situation where these two guys circle around each other, but the fight never happens. And now both of these guys have lost. All of the excitement is pulled out of the fight. We don't want another wasted super fight. We missed out on the Mikey Garcia-Lomachenko fight, and both of these guys have taken another loss. Like, we don't want to keep seeing this. We want to see the super fight that we want at the time that we want it. Errol Spence, Terrence Crawford makes all the sense to fight next. That fight needs to happen next because there's literally nothing stopping it. Because men lie, women lie, but the facts don't lie.